let's create a design in which multiple elements interact with each other transparently, and we want to be able to adjust elements of the design while building it so that in the end this looks like we want to. Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we are going to create this design so that you can adjust the details of the layout in nearly real time. Let's start with the base artwork, and we're going to take a look at this in the layers panel, and also the organization of the layers and the hierarchy of this document is of course important here. What we have here is a lot of ellipses. They are just red circles. We have a text object here, which is currently just red. Then we have two patterned rectangles. So here we've got a pattern and then a white rectangle in between and another pattern below that. So also this here is just a rectangle with a pattern. And we can use groups to build this, but then it's not as simple to just grab objects and move them around. So we are going to use layers to do that. So first of all, we're going to set up the layer in the background, and that contains all of these elements here. So I'm going to create a new layer and take all of these, move them in here, and then move that below the other layer, just like that. And then we can just show all these again. And I'm going to lock this layer. So I do not want to change it, but of course we can, and I'm going to show later on. And then what we want to get is that this text just punches all the way through this background here. So it's up here and it needs to punch a hole. So there are several things you can imagine to do that. You could make an opacity mask, and you could also make a knockout group. An opacity mask has the disadvantage that it's not easy to handle. The same goes for a knockout group when you actually create a group for that. The easiest would be to have them in a way that you can just grab them. And that is possible by building the knockout group in a certain way. So what we are going to do is take this text and assign an opacity of 0%. That is done in the transparency panel that you can see here, or by just entering 0 here. When you have this with 0%, then of course it's invisible. And now to get the knockout group, what we would have to do is select all of these and group them. But then, of course, we get a group, and it's not simple to move the single objects around. So what we are going to do is take another container element, which is this layer. So just target this layer and then go into the transparency panel again and turn on knockout group. So now we have a knockout group, and you see this punches all the way through all of the elements that are below. It doesn't punch through this because it's on top. This one is always on top, and you see now the preview gets a little butchered. So what we need to do is set this to the CPU preview, and then it's perfect. But we do not have a real-time preview. So also when we move this around, we do not see the pattern in real time. You can try, because it depends on the graphic card. So maybe your graphic card works with this, mine doesn't. What we can now do is just grab this, move it around. We can also grab these and move them around. What we can't do is click through here unless we just lock this, and then we can move those around. Also, if we knock this complete layer, then we can unlock this one and of course move those around that are on the background layer. So that's how you can build this and make this easily editable without having to enter in isolation mode or without having to just enter the editing mode for an opacity mask.